everyone. My name is Brianna, and I am a sophomore here at NC State University, double majoring in crop and soil sciences, as well as horticultural science. For my plant pathology project, I decided to research crown gall disease and look into the symptoms of that disease to then in return make an edible model. The main symptom of crown gall includes a round wart-like growth that is normally 2 inches or larger in diameter on the plant. They can appear just at the soil line or on lower branches and sometimes stems. And these galls can get so big and so hardened that plants may be unable to move water and nutrients up and become weakened, stunted, and may overall result in death. The bacteria that causes this disease is called Agrobacterium tumefaciens, and this enters the plant through wounds in roots or stems and basically causes these plant tissues to grow in a way that produces the swollen gall. Crown gall disease is important to the agricultural industry because this disease is very common, as well as that it's caused by a very common bacterium, which is the Agrobacterium tumefaciens, like I said earlier. Crown gall disease can usually be prevented by avoiding unnecessary wounding during the cultivation stages. Make sure you're using proper pruning and propagation tools so that wounding does not occur, as well as using careful sterilization and sanitation while planting the crops. Make sure you don't plant any already diseased plants. To create my edible model, I used chocolate wafer sticks, brownie mix, and chocolate sauce to piece it all together. I used the chocolate wafer sticks to represent a branch or stem on a plant. I then baked brownies using the mix and molded it together to form the rounded gall, and used chocolate sauce to hold it together. I actually then waited a few days and left this edible model on the counter so the brownie could harden and more represent a gall, as well as just hold the whole project together better.